hello to all of my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, Facebook fans, Maria's Arts fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine Show. I'm ready to do another, our third show of Maria's Arts Teaches Us to Paint. How are you today?
Hi, Alan. I'm great. Welcome back to the show. If you've seen it before, Maria's Ideas Teaches Us to Paint. I'm Maria DeSimone-Prasic, and I'm excited that we have our guest here, a friend from neighboring business district here, Mayor JoAnna Taylor. Thank you so much for joining us today. So
yeah, thank you for having me.
Yeah, we're excited.
Welcome aboard.
Yes.
Thank you.
Can you paint?
We'll see.
Oh, it's an adventure.
She will today.
There you go.
So, all right, let's get started. And we're going to paint this fun flowers today. All right? Now, this is just a suggestion. You can go with the flow and do your own thing, but I will help you and guide you with each step. But that's our inspiration here. I'm going to put that right there. All right, so first we have our design. If you get the kits from us, that comes in the kits. And I also have a video on Maria's Ideas Art, my YouTube channel, which it's a little 10-minute video that shows how to draw each design for each episode so that you can provide your own materials and paints and things like that. So what we're going to do is put the paper in place on top of the canvas and just hold it in place. If you're right-handed, hold it with your left hand. And you'll move the transfer paper. You put the transfer paper underneath. Like, remember carbon paper back in the day?
Can I call some people it carbon paper?
I know. Young people don't know what carbon paper is. And just move that.
I'm not that young. Yeah.
And just move the paper where you need it as you're drawing.
Oh,
but just try not to, you know, just, you can do this and move that, but try to keep the design in place. Otherwise, you're going to have to, you know, figure out where it was.
My tip to anybody watching, since I'm a simple man, I just put it down and it's about halfway there.
Yeah, but so you have to be able to move the transfer paper out from under it without moving the paper.
Watch what I'll do.
I see.
Okay, that's good. Perfect.
Yeah. Thanks, so just trace. I appreciate you letting me do that. I'm going to go in and start.
Yes,
I got
we're going
it halfway
to draw.
In, so we'll see what happens.
And you don't have to draw the little pickle on the design, just the flowers. And we're going to do some of the other things.
Thank you for clarifying that, teacher.
And so just draw. It doesn't have to be exactly the same. This is just to give you an idea so you don't have to make the wiggly lines, you know, exactly the way they
are. Should I put the dot?
No, I'm not sure what that was.
And well, this, you know, I got questions, so thank you.
Yes. Questions for Mayor JoAnna. She's doing good things in the area. We're so happy to have her here.
Thank
young,
you.
Young, trying. Fresh ideas. We have new businesses and so much more of a positive vibe and energy. I've been here 41 years in this neighborhood in business, and I've seen it since you've been here, and it's fabulous.
Well, thank you.
We're so happy.
Well, Mayor,
to have
I got to ask you a question.
Okay.
When did you become mayor, and why did you want to be mayor?
These are great questions. Mm-hmm. Well, the first one's easier. I became mayor last January.
You notice so I started out easy.
That was easy. I do appreciate that. So it's been 1 year.
Congratulations.
Yes. She's done a lot in
Thank
a year
you.
Already.
Yes. Well, we have, honestly, some very good leadership in the borough. And yes. I always got to give a shout out to our borough manager, Rick. He's
fabulous. Yes, he is.
And really, I feel like a lot of what I do is just supporting things that he already has, you know, has put in motion and mm-hmm. things that are going on. And that's really what he needed is just like some support. He's been working with a lot of groups. We have a lot of community partners and already had a lot of things mm-hmm. going.
And we things just take needed, time.
Exactly.
And you don't, even though you guys are doing wonderful things, you might not see it, but it's happening and it's
and
good.
He needs to have that support to make it happen. And that's
so
a lot of what
I try
to
then.
Do. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good way to say it. And, you know, learning how to do things. So part of the why did I do it part is, you know, just I'd lived here. Up in the
well,
hilltop
that's one of the
quite,
main things that
for
I
quite
got
a
from
while.
Talking to
yeah.
you previously.
And we love it. We are here by choice. We, my husband and I moved here. It's been almost 10 years up in the hilltop.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah. And there's a lot of things that we really love about it, and there's some things that we thought they just need a little more support.
Mm-hmm. And there are so many good people here, still here. A lot of younger people have been moving in. It's a lot less expensive. You can buy a house for the same amount or less than rent on the south side, and you have a yard and a garage.
Yeah.
And it's wonderful. We used to be the young people on our street. We renovated an old Victorian, and now we're the old people on the street, you know.
But
it's great. I love the mix, the diversity of people. It's really, I love it. We've chosen to stay here. I've been here, like I said, in business 41 years in the same place, and chose to live in the area, and it's great. So to see the business district come alive again, it's exciting.
I do see the renaissance happening with new places opening, Mayor, so I wish you well.
Thank you.
And thank you for answering my two questions with a short little answer. I respect that. And I'm still trying to trace.
Yeah.
I know. Look it up.
I think you did yours already, right?
I did. I'm traced.
Okay, here, I'll take those out of your way.
Right, we're done with these.
The stems and the berries, we're doing those all freehand.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Oh, I didn't realize there's berries. I better look at this.
I know.
So this is just, and you could see already what we have going on here. And as we paint these, as you can see from the design, all of your colors don't have to be in the same exact places. I'm going to suggest where we're putting them, but you're going to just have your own style and your own vibe the way you paint, and you should. They should all look different. And this design is going to be more expressionistic, I guess you could say, and a little looser. We're not trying to make this look like a photographic, you know, image of a rose, or these could be peonies or roses.
How's mine look to start?
That looks good. Very good.
Okay.
Sounds good. All right.
Feel better.
Yes.
A little nervous.
So we're going to start with the background that we're using acrylics. And whenever you paint with acrylics, typically you paint the background first, and then you layer, and anything that's in the foreground is on top. Ideally, if we had, say, 4 hours to do this class, I would have possibly painted the whole background one color, then draw the design on that. You could do it that way, too. But this works well because we want these reds and pinks to be bright. And if we had that blue underneath, that would tone them a little bit. So we'll get the truer bright red with the white canvas. So we're just going to block in and paint around them. So we're going to start with our 1-inch flat brush shader. Yes. And I usually dip this in the water first and then take the excess water off. Just dry that on your paper towel. And then I usually shape the bristles. What that does is it allows the paint to absorb better in the bristles, and always keep the bristles in the direction that they were created on the brush. So we're going
to... You heard that, Mayor.
Yes. So
I'm listening very carefully.
I mean, I'm just going to say, I do recall one time seeing you doing that to mix your paint.
Yeah, I did.
Like, look what that did.
I did, and thank you for not correcting me.
Yeah, I know. So
now we'll just remind you later. You know.
Don't want to smush up your bristles. You want to be kind to your brush.
No smush.
Okay,
today.
No smushing. So what we're going to do, and I'm going to fix my bristles. Okay, we're going into this really pretty aqua color, and we're going to put some on our, you know, grab some of that, and put some of this. Now, what I do is I always mix on my palette, if I'm using a couple colors, put them next to each other and introduce them to each other as you need them. So when I'm loading the brush, you could see how I'm flipping the brush back and forth, and what that does, it loads the brush, but it does not mess up the bristles, okay?
Oh yeah, it
and
does.
You wanna try to keep the paint from going up in the ferrule of the brush, which I am really bad at that. Mine is always, you know, and then your brushes get all messed up, but you know, if you can avoid it, that will keep your brushes nicer longer.
Teacher, I will try.
Yes. So we're cutting in. I'm going to start at the top and just kind of work my way down. And you can lay the brush down flat and rest it on the canvas and just pull it around like this. Or you can just use the corner. But what I do is if you lay the brush down on the canvas, let it rest on the canvas right here. You could see it's resting. That controls your hand a little. And then you just pull your hand around. So it gives you a nice clean edge, and then just move the paint around. If it tends to get a little, you see a lot of the texture of the canvas, you need either a little bit more paint. You might want to add a little bit of water.
So I should just smooth it out then?
You can, you know, if you leave it, the texture will dry like that, and that's actually very nice. I hope when we paint the flowers, I suggest leaving the paint a little thicker. This is like a medium body paint. If you use a really heavy body paint, that will definitely leave the nice texture, which is great, especially for this subject matter.
Yeah. Maria, by the way, how'd you come up with this? This theme?
I figured March is a good time for flowers to start popping up, and I'm usually inspired by the time of year and maybe what's going on, and I'm ready to see some flowers and some color. It's been a little dreary here lately in the Berg.
Well, Maria,
but except for those 370 degree days we've had in February, I'll take that.
Well, the other day, last week, right out my front door, I'm getting mail, and I didn't plant these flowers in my yard. White snowdrops were blooming. They just come up after I've been there 16 years and didn't plant them.
Nice. Maybe the birds planted them for you.
Well, they're consistent.
Yeah.
My birds were singing this morning.
Aww. Now, the other thing I'm doing, and you on the inspiration picture, you can see some white in the background. You can mix right on the canvas, too. So if I grab some of my white and I kind of throw it on the canvas, just to give it some interest, you can see I'm not blending it completely. That just gives the background just a little interest there. And you can certainly use a smaller brush for these other areas. But if you pick up the brush vertically and use the edge, it gives you that fine line that you need.
Thank you
to
for
just
teaching
move around.
Me. I'm doing that. Look at how I'm flipping this.
Yes, flip it back and forth. It loads the brush.
You can learn it too. We're trying to teach
That's
you.
Right.
Yes. And then we're just going to fill this in all the way around. And I would recommend covering up these lines a little. If you do watch the video and you use a pencil, same thing. Try to cover the pencil lines.
Great tip. Thank you.
Yeah. And you can still see through the paint somewhat anyway, depending on the color. And I just grabbed a little more white, and I'm mixing that in again. Just to break up the background. We want to see some brush strokes, more of a painterly look instead of it. It doesn't have to be a solid, smooth color.
And you don't see any sun on this, so I'm not sure.
No, we don't necessarily have our light source.
Okay, I just wanted to ask because you taught me that.
We do. If you look at the vase, one side is lighter, so I guess we do. But we're not, this is not, fancy still life or anything. We're just painting more of a stylized version.
Well, you taught me, so I got to bring it up. Thank you for the answer.
That's right.
So there, I have my background filled in, and you can see my white. Yeah.
You're much faster.
Yeah, I am. That's okay. That's okay.
I'm really concentrating here.
Yours is very perfect. It's very nice.
I know. When you're like, you can do kind of whatever you want. I'm like, oh, no, I'll do exactly very as you tell me to do.
And don't be afraid to mix in some white. You see how
it's the slowest in the bunch, so I don't know what you're talking about.
That's okay. And you can see
I'm getting there.
How the white just adds a little interest. And if you're working wet on wet like I am here, it's blending, one color is blending into the other, and then I'm getting a few other shades of this aqua color, which is really pretty, I think. I just think it's a good time of year.
Yeah, I love that.
Yeah.
It is a great color.
Mm-hmm. And then whenever you're done with your brush, either rinse it really well and set it aside or leave it in the water. The acrylics dry really quickly. And once they dry, you can get it back out with like a rubbing alcohol or a hand sanitizer. Mm. Will reactivate the paint and take it back out if it dries. And maybe it gets kind of gummy and messy, but I'm going to just make sure I rinse my brush really well. Okay, so the next brush I'm picking up is my half-inch flat shader. And I'm coming in and I'm painting I'm going to do the vase, and then I'm going to work on the large bright red areas. All right, so first I decided my vase is going to be like a pale pink with some shading on it, and we'll mix this color. I'll ask Alan and Joanna how they think we're going to achieve this color. We'll get to that in a little bit.
Whoa.
Great. So
can't wait.
Yes. Yeah. So I'm starting with some white on my palette, and I'm going to introduce a little bit of red to make a pink color.
Oh, we're going back to the red and white. Last time you had pink made for me,
I
appreciate it. It's so simple.
I did. Yes, and I'm just coming in. Again, I'm holding my brush vertically. I'm letting those bristles spread out, and I'm pressing down. You can see I'm pushing it all the way down on the canvas, and just let the bristles right here, put those on that line, and just pull one brush stroke just like that. Mm. It gives you a nice fine.
That's beautiful.
Straight
line.
That's
the advanced lesson right there.
Yeah.
And that's just having control of the brush. If you try to keep your hand steady, sometimes it's a little tricky. But if you let the brush rest on the canvas, it supports your hand. It keeps a little steady.
I'm trying that right now.
Yeah.
I'm able to keep it straight and round.
Good.
Here,
yeah. So I have.
Thank you.
Yeah. So I painted that vase pink, but I put some white on the right side, and I'm going to hit a little yellow on that later when I have yellow on my brush. But I do want to shade this a little bit now. I will come back whenever I do these dark areas here. But so I want, it's like a burgundy or a maroon color.
Ooh.
So with the colors that we have, what two colors do you think will make that shade? So it's not the bright red, but it's a version of, it's a red tone. Any ideas to make
some,
this burgundy color?
You're gonna need at least some of the dark blue in it, right?
I was gonna say
blue will work.
Oh, okay, no then.
Well, oh. I could tell when I said that, huh? Usually you start, if you start with the opposite color on the color wheel, that will knock a color back from its intensity and without making it muddy and dirty if you add. A lot of people think you add black. If you add the black, you
really?
But it would look a little dirty.
Okay.
But you'll see here, I'm going to take my red. I had a little bit of white on there. And I'm going to add green, which is the opposite color of the color wheel. Because
I got to learn that color wheel.
Yes. Yeah. What it's going to do, see that right there? Just that little bit of green.
Oh.
It makes it a pretty, wow. Like a burgundy
okay.
color.
I wouldn't have thought that.
Blue would also work.
I'm with you,
it would
there.
Be a
no
little,
clue.
The blue would lean a little more toward purple.
Okay.
Because red and blue make yeah. purple. But this gives us that very pretty, like a wine color yeah. or a maroon color. And I want that for this shade, oops, right here. I'm going to put this on the left side of the vase. Just one little brush stroke, maybe a little under this leaf. And I'm just going to pull the brush strokes down like that. And so, yeah, so to get back to our light source, we could say our light source is on the right side.
You know I had to ask.
Yes.
You've taught me.
You are a good student.
I do remember.
You do retain.
I have some
yes.
catching up to do.
No, you're good.
There I
go. I'm
got
just
it.
Painting.
I beat the mayor.
Not with the white, though. Look at me.
Yeah, you got to add some interest.
Man. But not that we're competing.
Exactly. No, not at all.
Not that we're competing.
No.
I take
not
that.
Not really. We sort of are, but we got a little girl power going here today, but you know.
I don't want to lie about just competing with myself. So
see?
Yes, we are a little bit.
All right, a little bit, just a little.
I like it. So you'll do your vase, the white and the pink, and then see once when it's wet, it keeps grabbing the other color. So I'm going to let that dry a little bit, and then I'll come back in and hit that again with. Once it dries, you can always add your highlights on top. The highlights are the fun part. But you can see this kind of gives you the suggestion of the light source being on the left side. So white, red and white to make the pink, paint your vase. And then red with a little, not like half green, half red. I'd say
just a touch.
A third green, little bit to achieve that pretty wine color. And I spilled, there's a little drop of red on my background, but we'll take care of that later.
Okay.
So I'm going in straight red. With my half inch shader. And what I'm doing here is I'm coming in again, I'm laying my brush down and I'm going to pull it around. I'm not worried about making these shapes too round, kind of give it some angles here. And that sort of suggests, you know, the way the petals lay on a flower, just makes it more interesting. So I'm leaving some lumpy areas. I'm coming in, and the spaces that we did draw here, again, we don't have to stay true to those exactly. That is just going to help you figure out where we're going to lay in some of those other colors. But you can see I covered that with the red. While this is still wet, I'm going to grab a little bit of orange and just lay it on top of the red, just
yeah.
here and there.
I love that.
And just, the light colors come forward, dark colors recede. So the orange is brighter than the red. So the orange is going to make that area of that petal just pop a little bit. Okay? So I'm going to do the same thing with the other two. I'm gonna let this dry just for a little bit. It dries really quickly, which is another reason why when you paint with acrylics, if you're blending, you kind of need to keep it moving because it, if you're trying to blend, because they do dry really quick. And so that could be a good thing or a bad thing depending on what you're trying to do.
Yes.
So you can see, yeah. So I'm just kind of coming in. You can see I'm leaving, blocking it, but I'm leaving those big areas. So I'm just gonna work on these two right now. And this one, I'm just going to put a touch of orange, not too much on this one. So I'm going to, I'm not rinsing the brush, but I'm just taking the extra paint off of my paper towel. So I still have that red on there. And I'm going to mix a pink because I want this section here of the flower to look like it's up higher. So I need it to be lighter. So I take the white, and there was already red on my brush, so I made some pink, but I feel like I want that a little bit brighter, so I add some white, and I'm coming in and just hitting those areas. So you could see that looks like it comes forward a little bit.
Yeah.
And you can see I'm blending it in with the other red because it's wet on wet. So I'm not mixing it and making a solid color. I'm leaving these brush strokes and give it some interest. You can see here, I'm not blending it. I'm just laying that on top. So they're mixing here and there where they transition from one color to the next, but I'm just leaving those brush strokes. And I'm going to do the same thing with my, this one. Now this particular red and white is making a particular pink color. If you want this to be more of like a bubblegum pink or a brighter pink, hot pink color, you can certainly buy a pink paint already mixed, and that will give you a brighter pink too. But we're gonna just work with what we have here. I think on my design, it looks more of a magenta pink, which I could probably do that. It would be easier if we had the regular or the pink already mixed, but that's okay.
We're having fun.
Yeah,
we're
it like that. So you can see just these brush strokes, like as you're adding this, because it's wet on wet, I have three or four different shades of pink in there too. And again, that's giving these flowers some interest there. The lines are just suggestions. So you don't have to make sure everything is right, exactly where the lines are. So I'm coming in, doing the same thing with the red here. All right, and I didn't even rinse my brush. So I have pink in there, I have red in there. These are just very fun flowers, simple, letting the colors just kind of mix right on the canvas. But I would say try to keep those brush strokes with some angles in them, and that's what gives it that sort of that layered petal look. And then as you're
doing well, Mayor.
Thank you, sir.
Mm-hmm. They look good. And then I would say make the brush strokes, the shape of the flowers, the way the petals may be laying, paint the brush strokes in that direction. So if the petal is going left to right, that brush stroke, it will help suggest that that's the petal shape.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank
so,
you.
Yeah, yeah. So you can see here, if I come this way, that's the petal. So just paint the direction of the petals.
Once I get my, I'm a little bit of an outliner, but once I outline it, I'm gonna come back and pedal myself.
And then you can add some orange
just
or white.
Just pretend you're teaching your kids.
That's right.
There you go.
Go in strong.
That's right. And then I'm going to grab, again, I'm going to mix a pink. And the acrylics dry darker. So as you're mixing on your palette, keep in mind, it's going to be a little darker than what you're seeing there. I also work with watercolors, and that's the opposite. They dry lighter, so I have to...
Okay, so you need that good eye like you have.
Well, you get used to it. It's like anything. The more you do practice, you get your trained eye, you know.
Well, this is only my third experience painting in 50
You're doing a good
years.
Job. Just good job. So start with the true red, and then come in with the pink... So the real bright red.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And then the pink is some layers on top that come forward.
Thank
yes.
you. Thanks for your guidance.
Yes. And then I was throwing it. Yeah, that's okay.
I'm all over the place.
Yeah, start with the red. You want to start with the darker color, the bolder colors, and then build up the dimension with the lighter shade. So if you start with the lighter one, it's harder to do that. You have to go back in and add the dark and
You're explaining me for all you amateurs out there.
Yes.
And when you go back in.
Right. With the watercolors, you have to leave your white areas. Right. But you have to kind of think ahead a little and know where your light colors are going to be. But with acrylics, it's so easy to add them. You add them. You build those layers up.
And I'm living proof of that right now.
Yeah, exactly. So I have the red. I started with the red, came in with some pink, some orange. And again, I've just kind of laid them in just where I feel like I needed those sections that break up a little bit. That looks beautiful.
Thank you.
And now, I'm going to let this dry. I'm going to let that dry and work on the other ones, because if I put too much of the white right now, it's just going to blend in too much, and I don't want it to blend in as much. So the smaller flowers, this one, and this one is a little medium size. They're more the orange and orange. They could be maybe a poppy. I have poppies, the oriental poppies that grow in my garden.
Oh, that's nice.
They're very pretty orange.
I love it.
Yeah. So I'm doing the same thing here, but I'm starting with the bright orange. Then I'll introduce a little touch of, let me go this way, a little touch of yellow and red. Let's see here. But you can see I'm purposely covering up that background color a little bit. But just keep those brush strokes in the direction of the petals. And then I'll come in with some yellow, because the yellow is brighter. And that makes that pop a little bit. So very just suggestions of petals. Again, it's just laying them in where you kind of need a little pop of color. See here. I think I'm going to put a little bit of pink. Now I have yellow on my brush, so it's going to be more of a salmon color. Red and white. Put that here. Okay.
I need to cover up my lines a little more. Yours are covered more. Mine are.
They will. That's where when you add some more white to the pink, the white's more opaque too. It will cover. That looks good though. But I'd say make it a little bit lighter now so that you bring.
Pops more.
Yes. The lighter it is, that the more it's going to come forward for you. And this one, I think I'm just going to add more yellow. So we're just doing, you could see they're just very quick brush strokes. We're just layering the colors. And just, I'm kind of going around in circles with the brush strokes, but angling them so that.
This is a great theme.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. So always start with the darker colors, Alan.
I know. I went the opposite because I had pink.
That's okay.
I'm going dark now.
In the end, it will still be nice.
I'll go back red. I promise you.
Yeah. Okay.
So you too can make mistakes like I did.
Yeah. There are no mistakes in art.
All right. Well,
no.
Misdirection.
Way I look at it. That looks good. See, now you have sometimes you don't know that you have a style or a certain way that you paint until you do it.
That's not
you
so I
have
can see.
A lot of very curvy shapes, which are beautiful. Like, I love it. They're
different though.
Yeah,
now
and
I'm
you don't
I'm
know.
Second and, guessing my different.
No, no. That's beautiful. But you could see you're just going with it, and that's what your hand and your eyes want to do, and that's why you have a style that you didn't even know you had.
I didn't even know.
Wow.
They're beautiful.
I have a style.
They're very nice. And okay, so let's see. I'm sticking with still the same brush. I'm going back in to make that the wine burgundy maroon color. And what did we say we used to make that?
Oh, the dark green with the red.
Mm-hmm. It is a red tone. So we're starting, you always start with that color family. Start with that color. Introduce the green, and I'm not even cleaning off my brush, but taking the excess off. And what I'll do is,
you're giving me confidence. I don't have to keep dipping.
No. When I go into my colors in my palette, if I go in the edge, it doesn't contaminate the color pot completely. I just usually go in on the edges. And so I'm going to add a little bit of green. And like you said too, you could add a little bit of blue. It would kind of lean a little more toward a purple, which is beautiful too for this. And what we want to do is achieve a very nice dark wine color. I feel like mine I did a little bit darker. So I just added a little bit more green. And then I'm coming in this section in the center. We want to give that some depth. That gets that hole in the center.
How do you do that?
With the darker colors, because the dark colors recede and the light colors come forward, which is why you need the lighter colors to bring those areas
forward. Now I understand, yes.
Yeah. It's around too much. Okay.
I know, we're tight spaces here.
No, you're not good.
Over here.
If you don't know each
ladies.
Other before the class, you know each other after the class. That's right. That's right.
We can't miss, though.
No. All right, so I filled those in with that. I think I'm going to grab a smaller brush now. I need a little bit more. So if you want a little darker, just add a little bit more of the green. And we may have to come in and hit this again, because this is kind of wet on wet. And as it dries, if it's still wet and you keep going over it, it will pick up the paint that's already there. If you want it to add a layer, you need to let it dry a little bit. So I'm going to put that brush in the water, and I'm going to grab a little round, like a little round liner brush. And I'm going to make the same mixture, the red, and introduce a little green. I'm going to put a little bit of that blue in like you suggested.
Whoa.
That looks
I
want to like.
See that, yeah.
Way to go, Mayor.
Ooh, that's Thank pretty,
you.
Too.
No.
It's a little...
Okay,
it's,
I see.
You can see.
Yeah.
It's pretty, too.
A little goes a long way, though, with that.
Makes it a hint more brown, maybe, but it's still nice. There's no wrong. So you could see I popped that in here, and then I'm going to still grab more of that maroon color. And I'm just going to add just a couple little wispy lines here and there, just around, and maybe one here. And that did dry some, so that's good. Now I can add some of my other layers. On this one, I want to add some, so you can see since this dried a little, now my yellow is laying on top of this orange instead of blending in. I want this to pop.
Oh, yours looks wonderful there.
See?
Popping look at that.
Yeah, but it needed to dry a little.
I think that's, I need a little, mine came a little heavy. I need to dry a little bit.
As it dries, it will lay on top. They look beautiful. And then, so what, typically what you do is you add your darker colors, your midtones, your lighter, your highlights and light, those, which is the, I love doing the highlights. That's the best part, right?
Yeah.
That's at the end. So as it's drying, you'll come in and just see where it needs a little pop come forward.
Pop. Yeah.
So if you're starting with the dark red, you can use the pink for a highlight. You can use the yellow. You can add white to the yellow or to the orange. I'm just using the yellow here, and I'm just going to pop just right here. So next to that darkest area of the center, I want some highlights in that. Do you see that little stroke of yellow next to that dark? That made that recede a little, because that light, our eyes, the cones in our eyes, see that yellow first and it comes forward. So we're doing that. Yeah, and then let's see. Oh, I need some dark. I'm going to do the same thing with white too. And then you want to, you know, as you're painting, then you look at the whole thing. Something you could even squint your eyes and see if your eye is just going to one particular section and it's not really moving around. If you want that as the focus, that's fine. But if you want to have a nice composition in your eye to kind of flow around the artwork, if you squint your eye and see if it gets stuck on one spot, then you need to remedy that by maybe adding some other highlights in another spot or some darker tones just to so that it's balanced a little bit. So I'm taking some white with my little brush and I'm coming around like this. Same brush stroke. So whichever, you have really pretty curves. So you use your same brush strokes when you add your highlights. Alan, his is interesting too. So just whatever brush strokes you're using.
Off the charts.
No, I like it. Yeah, it looks good.
Great.
Just use your same brush strokes. Just add the highlights as you're kind of coming around. Yep. And they really should all look different. We're all different. And
I guarantee
should,
mine will.
Yeah. That's a good thing.
I didn't say it was bad.
It's a good thing.
A beautiful thing.
Red. And so I mixed a little, another bit of that dark. So we had a very a fun project I did with the mayor, JoAnna, in the community.
That's what this was reminding me of.
Is that when July?
In September.
We had like a fall.
Oh, really?
That's what these flowers remind me of. It's hanging up in the borough building.
Yes. So Rick Hopkinson, who he had talked to me about maybe doing some artwork for the borough building. And I said, well, sure, I can create some artwork. And he had suggested some poppies, something red, something colorful for in the hallway. And I thought, yeah, sure, I can do that. But why not make it a community project? So I painted, was it three canvases?
Three big canvases. Yeah, really big.
4 foot by 5 foot. I painted them, drew them like a paint by number. And then we set them up. We blocked off the street. We got colors that we used.
You were doing this in the street.
Yes, yeah. we blocked off the street. We had music and food, and it was great. And then I used colors from the logo. They were inspired from the Mount Oliver Borough logo, which is really nice.
So nice.
And so what I did was everyone that came, anybody that showed up, we had little kids, we had grandmas, all ages in between, and we all painted these paintings together. And they come out beautifully, and they hang in the borough building. So if you go there,
wow.
Yeah, and I remember your little kids there.
My six-year-old, my four-year-old, they were in there painting.
And it was fantastic. So the artwork is created by the community. So it's really, that was really special. Yeah.
Thanks for sharing that,
that's
JoAnna.
That's amazing.
That was fun. Yeah. They have a lot of good things. We have
live music. I hope to do more things like that.
Oh, definitely.
Art, I think.
Oh, yeah. Art, music.
Yes.
Good things. So,
and we've been doing a lot more events like that. So that's when, you know, again, Rick and the borough, they've been doing a lot of planning. It started as a few summer events, and it got bigger, and then it turned into lots of summer events, and then it turned into fall events where there's live music a lot.
You're seasonal here.
Yeah.
They watch movies. I don't know if the bus drivers love it as much.
When we close down Brownsville Road.
Close the street down. You have to go the other way.
Main street.
We do know.
They just go around.
Right on it.
Did you?
Oh, yeah.
They just go around the block.
Yes. Yeah. It's usually just a small part, but yeah, we have a newer parking lot area where so sometimes we utilize that instead of closing off the street.
Well, there are side streets you can circle.
Yeah.
If you know them.
The bus drivers.
They have live music too on the deck. It's just wonderful.
They're driving a little bigger vehicle than those cars.
They are.
Friends of mine are Port Authority drivers, so they've told me that.
Yeah.
And they try not to run over people.
There you go.
They do a good job of not doing it.
Well, I'll have to share with you. I worked in downtown Pittsburgh since I was 15 years old.
Oh, wow.
And I learned how to jaywalk with Vic Cianco directing traffic.
He was great.
I actually met him, and just a legendary guy. And he'd go, come on, kid, make it quick.
Aw. He was fun. Okay, so I'm coming. I have my flowers. I think they still need to dry a little bit. I'll add some little, tweak it a little bit with some highlights and shadows. But I'm coming in to paint my leaves. And you guys are doing good, so just keep doing what you're doing. They look good. Maybe, can we just take a second and grab your canvases and just show just the progress? They're so cool. Look how interesting already.
I'm so far behind.
No, they look great. You see? They look different already. I like it. Everybody has their own style.
Thank you, teacher.
They look good. All right, that's good. All right, so I'm coming in with the same half inch.
The entertainment.
That grunting noise that you heard was Jono. He's hiding on the other side.
Hello.
That's some of Jono's artwork behind us. All right, so I have my half inch flat shader. And I'm coming in, I'm just using this. Usually when I paint leaves, I don't necessarily use the green, kind of just straight green out of the bottle or tube. I like to mix some earthier tones with it, or I'll double load or triple load my brush. But for in this case, because of the colors that we're using, the color palette, I want this strong, bright green, just the way it is. So I'm going to take some green. I am going to introduce some other colors on the leaves too. I have like 3 or 4 or 5 different colors on my leaves, but I am going to start with this green. You can see I'm loading my brush, flipping it back and forth, and I'm coming in and I'm just going to paint my leaves like this. And then I'm just blocking them in. You can, if you choose to, you can paint maybe the direction that the veins of the leaves would be. You don't have to, but it does kind of nice build up a nice texture.
Well, the theme has been direction, so yeah. I'm trying to follow that.
And that's anytime you're painting something, if it's fur or feathers or something, you know, you keep in mind the direction that it is on your subject matter, and you paint so that the texture of the paint helps to achieve a certain look. Now, this leaf, I just kind of pulled my brush.
Oh, yeah.
Like this on an angle and let it create like that little serrated edges, you know, if you wanted to do that. And then
check that out.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice little texture.
Just that is awesome.
Okay. Thanks.
I'm going to attempt it.
I'm going to attempt
no
it.
No way.
I'm going to attempt it.
I'll show you. I'll show you with the brush stroke again.
Okay.
And so we just kind of went like this. I laid the brush sort of like a little
Where's
bit of an angle.
Where's that 10-minute video right now for me?
Exactly. Just kind of do something like that. And now I'm going again because I'm painting wet on wet in this. With this type of painting, I went into this aqua color, the same one that's in our background, and I'm just laying some brush strokes on top, and it's mixing in with the green, but it's giving us some dimension on the leaves. And then I'll come in with the smaller detail brush too, and then I'm going to even take a little bit of yellow, and I'm mixing that with the green, and it's making a real bright limey green, and I'm going to hit
that.
And you can see again, I started with the darker color. When you introduce that lighter color, how it brings it forward a little bit. And we also have our light source, right, Alan, is on our right side.
Yes.
Yes.
I am aware.
Where's the light source? And so there, you know, have a couple leaves go in there. I'll do the veining and some of these other, the contour lines with my smaller brush. But while I have this same brush, I just rinsed it. As the paint kind of builds up in your brush, sometimes the bristles will come apart. Just rinse it and get that excess paint out of there.
Mine are staying together pretty good, thanks to you.
Yeah, and then that way your bristles will come together nicely again.
He can be taught.
That's right. So what I'm doing is I'm loading my brush with the green again, and the stems we're doing freehand, okay? So I'm going to...
Oh, that's right.
Yes, we're loading this brush, the same one. We're holding it vertically because we don't want that stem to be a big line. I mean, you can if you want to. You want it to be a big, chunky stem, that's fine. But
I might.
He might. You never know with him. But we're going to hold the brush this way and use the chiseled edge to make that line. So
I
I'm
like
going
that
to.
Chiseled edge.
Yeah. So I'm just going
to
do like a little.
Thanks, Joanna, for pointing that out.
Looks good.
Yeah. So I'm just doing like a little V shape right here. Kind of where the stem would flare out and to grab that blossom. Just did that little bit there, and then I'm just going to hold my brush vertically and pull it down like that.
Ooh.
Now that got a little chunkier than I wanted it to be, so I might go back in with the aqua and make that a little narrower looking off the sea. This one, there's one here, because that's the stem. It holds this one. Then this one, I'm coming here. I feel like it's getting a little bit too wide, so I'm going to take some of that extra paint off.
I'm just amazed how that green makes it look so brown.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then I'm going to curve this one down a little. This one's up here. And bring this one here. And you can add stems anywhere you'd like. This one, I was just trying to balance a little. You can see I made these certainly thinner. So that one up there, I'll see. I may adjust that one.
How do I make the yellow sort of brownish? Because
what's the opposite on the color wheel?
I don't
of
know.
The yellow.
She can put you to work.
Is it purple? Purple?
So then it'd be yellow, red, and blue.
So if you want, you can add a little, you can just add blue and purple are similar. So if you, since you don't have purple, you can make purple first. I would just add a tiny bit of blue.
Because I was going to do it in the top level there.
Yeah, just add a little bit of blue to the yellow, and that'll give you.
Okay.
We'll try with the. See, it depends on the blue that you have. It depends on the yellow that you have. If we take a little bit of yellow, add a
I'm
little bit of blue.
I'm not cleaning my brush, so I'll see.
No, see, it's too green. You can add a little bit of red and a little bit of blue. So the three primary colors make more of a brown.
Okay.
When you mix them. It's just the amounts that how you mix them in.
Okay.
Okay, so I have my stems. I'm letting those dry for a second, and I'm coming in with my little brown liner brush. And I'm going to add some of the veins in the leaves. So I'm coming in with the white. I'm just going to add a little here and there, a couple little brush strokes. And whenever you want to keep that point on your brush, you just twirl the brush as you're loading. There's still some green in there. Just pull it and twist it in your hand, and that keeps that point on the brush. So I just want just a couple little, not everywhere, just a couple little hints right there. And then I'll see if I needed to add, I might want to add just a little white here and there, wherever I need something to kind of pop a little. And on the design, I take that back. We're going to work with our blue after. So I'm going to paint my berries. Now this is the half inch filbert. It's a shader or a filbert. It has that curved top.
Okay.
And anytime you're painting something that has a round, like we could use this for the flowers as well. We just chose to use the other one, but this would work too. But we're going to use this to paint our berries. And these berries, I'm not sure what kind they are. This is more of a stylized bouquet, the okay. berries. They're green. I just wanted them to still be green just because of the composition, you know.
Doing that freehand will be an adventure.
No, you'll be good because it's all on the brush. So I'm loading my brush with the green, and I'm just going to, so I'm going to first do a little dot where I think I want them to be, because I want them on either side. We have them on either side of the stem, and then we'll connect them with a little. So I'm going to say, I want this one to overlap. So there's going to be one here, so I have, say that's going to be my berries here. So I'm taking my brush and I'm going to put a generous amount of paint on the brush. And if I just lay the brush down like this, not the whole, not necessarily pulling it, but just laying that tip and pushing a little bit. You see, it gave me a little, it doesn't have to be perfectly round because we're going to come up with our little detail brush and we can do like a little trim it.
I'm going to practice that on my plate though first.
Yeah, you could do that.
Like, I'm going to give it a
now,
little practice.
If you're not afraid of the paint, you can also do this. You can put your finger in and you can do that. And you can make a nice little.
I have fond memories of finger painting.
So you can.
Yeah.
It's acrylics. It washes off. So.
And thanks for the apron.
Oh, absolutely. So you can see. Now, if I push down too far and it's not as round, then I just do two. I'll do one brush stroke this way and one this way. You can do it in two parts. You could even flip and turn the brush.
Okay.
And I don't want them to be like, they don't have to be perfectly round, you know. There's something in
nature.
I'll try
to make them smaller than my apples that I made.
Yeah. In the red barn. You did a good job, though. You did really good.
Thank you.
Well, we were laughing because the apples, in comparison to the trees, if it was in real life, the apples were like volleyball size.
I like my apples.
Yeah. They were good. Okay. And let's see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. There's always a horn blowing up here, this intersection.
What size brush again did you use for the stems? Not the big one.
I use the flat shader, and then you hold it on its chiseled edge. This, hold it vertically to get, and you can even practice that on your plate too if you like.
That's a great idea. Yeah. I am going to practice that.
And I have more plates if you need one.
Yeah, don't
you want
turn
a,
it
you
over.
Want a
we
clean
don't
one?
Mess up
you could?
Yeah, I might take another one.
Okay.
I mean, I might still come back to this one, but I.
Yeah, there you go.
Perfect. Oh yeah, I'm getting a little wide. I see. Okay. Ooh.
So you just don't press.
Yeah.
Just kind of lightly put that chiseled edge. You can use the little round brush too, but it's just nice. Yeah. Nice. And it's usually easier if you do it faster. You kind of get an idea of where it's going to go and just got to do a big brush stroke.
Okay.
If you do it too slow, it's going to be too jaggy looking. And So you just got to like hold your breath maybe and you just go for it. That's that's the best way to do it.
To go for it.
That's it. That's all you got to do. And then I'm going to connect.
Oh yeah, it's a little wide. See.
And that's okay. Mine did the same thing. So now you know, just don't press, put enough.
I'm beyond
like wide, put enough paint on the brush, but then don't press it as hard. And I'm connecting here my little stems. And then I'm going to, while that's still wet, I'm going into the blue. Now my blue looks like it has a little, it's starting to dry on top. I have to add a little bit of water. You can also keep a spray bottle when you're painting with acrylics, especially if you're painting in the summertime.
Jono?
Yeah.
Spray bottle.
Wrong deer.
Just kidding. We've got to have a little fun here.
Need some sand from the river.
Yeah, there you go.
Bring it.
I have it.
Now, what I'm doing here with my little round brush is I'm just putting a little contour line, just a little suggestion. Again, these are more of a stylized flower, not necessarily something that you would see in nature. I don't know. We're taking artistic license here, and I'm putting this little pop of blue, like little C shapes. I'm drawing like a little, just to accent them a little bit, and on there. And then I'm going to do the same thing on my leaves. And then around my flowers. Just because I like the color, this blue with this composition and this color palette. And I just wanted to introduce this blue. So I'm just coming in so this can act as a bit of a color, like a shadow. So you can see here, I'm adding that little bit of blue there. Just here and there. Again, just some little accents. So anyway, I just add that little pop there, and I need so, and then I have my little. I'm good cleaning this brush.
I gotta practice.
Yeah,
practice makes perfect. You can do it. So I'm putting some little white highlights.
Yeah, it might work.
On the berry. So I'm taking that same little round brush, and I'm just putting a generous amount on the brush, and just like a little suggestion of a highlight. I don't like that one. Okay. Here. And then I'll kind of assess the situation here and see, do I need any white highlights while I have my, maybe put a little white here. And I think I want to put a little bit of yellow in there. And then I'm just looking at the overall painting and see where I might need a little highlight or shadow. That stem kind of does bother me up here. It's a little too wide. So I'm taking the background color and I'm just going over part of that stem, just like that. So you can see. And not every stem's going, doesn't have to be the same size, right?
No, but that's,
mine aren't.
Two of mine are a little wide. I'm
they look
come
good.
Back
you guys did really
mine
good.
Look like 79 right now. So.
79.
Route 79.
Oh. Yeah. And don't forget, you need one of your that dark center in your big flower
I
up there
that.
Too.
Yeah. I got distracted with all the other effluvia there.
So I'm just looking now. I'm looking. I feel like this area here, I feel like it needs to just pop a little bit more. So I'm going to make. I like that pink you did on your vase. So you must have used more red.
I did. I went a little lighter on some of the.
Yeah.
Very creative, JoAnna.
So nice.
Thank you. I did add in a stem over here because I felt like that flower was flying.
Nice.
There's
too much.
A pop in there.
So mine
is
too. Go back a little. I think it's fine. It's beautiful.
I think on the design there
maybe
was the blue
touched.
That went that way
yeah.
and they touched, but mine's not touching either. Good eye.
No, I mean you
Mayor,
no,
good.
Like,
I'm going to do one
I'm
on mine
saying
too.
I added it in.
No.
It hit me. The creative juices just
they are
struck in the moment and I had the.
Well, you see, you inspired me. I added one on mine, too, because mine was just flopping around out there, too. There. Okay. So, yeah, I feel like it needs... I did use when I did this... I actually created this in a computer just to... But I had this brighter pink, but we don't have the bright pink here, so that would have been pretty. I don't have it. So I'm going to use red... More of the white. He must have really.
I didn't give my leaves much. I need to get a little color.
Yeah, they need a little oomph, little some veining.
They got a little wet, and I thought I'd let them dry, and then I forgot about
them. They look great, though. So you could use the little round liner brush to do some of the veining, and the little, I added some of the, yep, that works.
Okay.
And if it's stiff, it might be some of that. There you go. And just add, you can use the aqua color I used, the lime color, white, just to give them a little interest. And then you can also use that color to trim the berries, too, if you'd like. You don't have to use the blue. We could use the bright green, or it's your painting. So, yeah, I feel like that needs just to pop a little bit here and there. And you could see now I'm going in different areas than I was before, and that brings those forward, some of those lines. And then I feel like my red needs to just be a little more intense. Oh yeah, see right there. So you may have to go back in with the darker.
I think just I'm gonna have to do a little.
Just to give it a little. Sometimes it gets covered up too much. Mm-hmm. And I think that's it for mine. I don't want to, like, you know, you can look back on the art the next day or something, come back in. You can always add some other layers, but sometimes it's a good idea to not, you know, mess
overdo
around with it too much. You got to know when to stop.
That's right.
Yes. So I'm saying that's it for me. I'm going to always sign your artwork or put your initials or something. I'm going to do. Yeah.
Where?
You can do this. You can do it on the back, too.
Okay. I'll do it on the back. Yeah. Mine's real simple. A.O.
Yeah. A.O. So, you know, whatever. Just look at it and see if everything looks balanced. You can kind of keep playing around with it forever, right? You have to know when to stop, but just where I'm just looking at my little highlights of the last thing I'm doing here. Just a couple. And I think we're good. Okay, I'm finished. I believe Mayor Joanna is done. And Alan, let's see how they look. They look great. You guys did a very nice job.
Thank you so much. You were a great teacher.
Yeah, I know. It feels like art class again. Like, are we going to hang out in the hallway?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You just hang your little...
This one's going up,
find your clip. You can hang it up.
You ladies are outstanding with what you did.
Yours is fantastic. I love seeing all the differences in them. It's really cool.
Nice. Very nice. Great job. And then, so next episode, we're going to paint... This is a view from the West End. Overlook. A little suggestion of the city in there. A little more... abstract too, but of our that tree, that really wonderful
I
tree
love
that's
that
out there.
View. Love that view.
This
is
a sunrise. A lot of sunrise in the city from that view.
We'll so know
that,
where the light's coming from.
Yeah.
But you'll have to check back to see who the special guest is. So we will have one. So
we like
that's
the
it.
We like to tease with it. Thank you for watching.
Yes.
We appreciate you watching us everywhere on Facebook, YouTube.
Yes.
And wait till the next show. We're gonna have some more fun. My third picture and painting. I'm so proud of it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.